It's the NFL on EA Sports.
And we've got a pair of teams who not long ago had more Super Bowls than anybody else.
It's the Boys and the Niners.
Next on Madden NFL 25.
Now from the home of the 49ers, Levi's Stadium in Santa Clara, this is EA Sports coverage of the National Football League. Good to be in the booth with Greg Olson. I'm Mike Tirico. Greg, this is a passing league. You know that from your days. It's evolved even more into a game in the air. And boy, we have a couple of quarterbacks who know all about moving their team via the pass.
Yeah, and I think we're going to see this ball thrown early and often throughout the game. And anyone who loves offensive football, this is certainly a treat. And you said it, Mike. This league has turned more and more with each passing season into a passing league. If you can't throw, if you can't generate points through the air and explosive plays, it is going to be very difficult to compete and win week in and week out in today's modern NFL.
Here's Jake Moody to get this one kicked off. And off we go from Santa Clara. Kevontae Turpin on the return. And he'll be brought down past the 25. Decent field position to start this drive. Cowboys coming out. As usual, it's Dak Prescott leading the way. Led the NFL in touchdown passes, Greg, a season ago. Already his ninth year at the helm for the Cowboys.
There aren't many quarterbacks in this league who come under the microscope as often as this guy does. I mean, he isn't perfect by any means, but you can certainly do a lot worse than having him lined up as your guy leading your offense. He has the athleticism to bail himself out of bad situations, but also the arm talent to make every throw on the field. So as long as he protects the ball, that's been the biggest thing in his career. If he can do that, man, he's as good as they come in this league. This is a great example here of just not getting too complicated as an offensive coordinator. Who's one of your best players on the field, and how do you get the ball in his hands?
An enviable spot to operate from. Here's second and inches.
Yeah! Here we go! Right check! 26!
We'll go play action. It's Prescott. The open man is Tolbert. And he's going to be brought down up past the 45.
These crossing concepts are frequently used, Mike, throughout the entire game, all across the league. And what it does is it creates a lot of natural rubs. You run out the backside of the defense and rely heavily on the yards after the catch, and it's exactly how they're able to pick up this big game.
Dak going to throw it here on first down. They'll come up now for second down and four. Play fake. Prescott. Nowhere to go. He is taken down.
In the midst of a tight game like that, you're looking for every play that you can make to try to gain advantage. And if you can continue to get after the quarterback, disrupt the rhythm and timing of this quarterback in the second half, that could be the difference of you being able to pull away.
Work to do following the sack. It is third and long. A shotgun snap for Prescott. Throwing right. It's taken in. And he'll be out of bounds inside the 30-yard line. They get the conversion on third down. It was a gain of 27.
These third down conversions are just so important, Mike. Everybody stresses we want to possess the ball, give our offense as much opportunity to end as many drives as we can, scoring points. So if you want to stay on the field, you better be good on third down.
First and 10.
Yeah, here we go. I take the play.
From the shotgun, it's Dak. This is intercepted. Picked off by Diamador Lenore. Still going. And he is going to score. A pick six for the touchdown. Well, that changes the story quickly. Looked like a very nice opening drive to start. Instead, Greg, it goes back the other way, and the defense scores first.
And Mike, early on, that's exactly how they drew it up. They wanted to come out and establish themselves with this first drive of the game. And then all of a sudden, disaster strikes. Not only do they turn the ball over, the defense is able to take it all the way back for the pick six.
Now Jake Moody for the extra point. He gets it to go, and the 49ers will take a 7-0 lead. So, following that touchdown, Moody is back out to kick it off. On the return, here's Turpin. Now an opening past the 30. And this will work out quite well. They'll get it all the way out to the 30-yard line. The Cowboys' offense ready to see what they can do. They are obviously still smarting from that pick six a moment ago. Quick 7-0 hole. Try to start digging out now with first and 10. First carry now for Rico Dowdle. They'll work now on 2nd and 4. Operating from the gun. Here's Dak. Quick throw, taken in, and he'll be taken down. The gain is 6, and it's a new set of downs. He picked up the first down.
One of the easiest ways to negate these really good pass rushes in the NFL, Mike, is just to simply get the ball out of the quarterback's hand as fast as possible. And sometimes it's by design, sometimes it's based on need. But really nice job there by the quarterback, getting into the hands of his receiver, and then see what he can do after the catch.
Trying to find some place to go, but nothing developing. Tackled behind the line. It's a loss of 1.
Every team makes an emphasis on winning first down, but as a defense, when you're able to take them back for a loss, 2nd and long, you can really become more of a pass-centric defense and really tips the scales into your favor.
On 2nd down, it's Dak. He's going to run it.
Initially, Mike, a really good job by the defense. Nowhere to go with the ball for this quarterback. He's forced to pull it down and turn into a runner. Little slow reaction, and he's able to actually pick up a pretty good game.
Here's a 3rd down and 4. Now, Prescott. Here's a screen coming for Dowdle. Give him 13 on that screen play. And a 1st down.
Every once in a while, it just comes down to you need somebody in the huddle to just make a play. And it wasn't a whole lot fancy here. The quarterback just dumps the ball down, a quick underneath completion. And then really, it's the yards after catch that did the rest. And that's what it takes. You're not always going to have the perfect play. You're not always going to dial up the perfect play against the perfect look. Sometimes players need to make plays, and that was a good one there.
Now a 1st and 10 from the 38-yard line. Yeah! Prescott now. It's going to be pulled in by Dowdle. And they'll get about half of what they needed. It's a pickup of 5 and sets up 2nd and 5.
Receiver just finds himself in a really nice groove, and there's these weird times in the game, Mike, where it just seems like every ball comes your way, every play they call, you're wide open, and you just find yourself in one of those grooves that athletes talk about. So they got to continue to ride the hot hand, because right now on that field, there's no mistaking who it is.
To the outside, looked in by Lamb, and he's gonna have a 1st down. He's forced out. Nice pickup of 9.
Not a whole lot complicated about this play, Mike. That was understanding where the holes of the defense were. Remember, in this zone coverage, you got to find green grass, get past the first down marker, be friendly to the quarterback, and then the ball has to be out on time before those zone defenders can react to the receiver. It's exactly how it played out here. You can drop all the fancy plays you want, but when the quarterback and the receiver see it through the same set of eyes, it's virtually impossible to stop. Certainly not the biggest play of the day, but a good example of picking up positive yardage, staying ahead of the chains by a well-timed ball and a well-timed route.
Yeah, here we go.
He'll throw again. Dak toward the sideline. That's pulled in by Lamb.
There's this misconception out there, Mike, that in the NFL, you have to run the same amount of run plays as you do pass plays. And as you're seeing in this drive, you can fall on one side of that coin a little bit more as long as you're able to remain effective and efficient. So far, their passing game has dominated here early, and that last pickup leads to a first down.
A short throw caught by Ferguson. And the Cowboys are going to be set up with a first and goal on a pass play that moves them down to the one.
It's been a really good drive so far, but what I really like, Mike, is they're down here in the red zone, and they continue to attack. Now, not quite a touchdown, but with first and goal, this defense certainly has their back against the ropes.
Prescott again. He's got his big tight end, Jake Ferguson. Touchdown, Dallas. Greg, it's the quarterback's best friend, and you were that guy for a lot of years. The tight end in a tight area with man coverage.
Yeah, and it's really twofold, Mike, right? First and foremost, we see so many of these tight ends around the league that now have gotten to the point where one-on-one matchups, that's advantage offense. But then even in the cases they don't create great separation, Mike, it's their size, their catch radius. It's such a friendly target for the quarterback that when things get tight in the red zone, they look to the tight end.
The extra point by Aubrey is good. The Cowboys will tie things up at 7-7 here in the opening quarter. So back to level after the touchdown and time for the kickoff. Deebo Samuel gonna get a chance to return it. He'll work his way across the 25-yard line. Here come the 49ers, and they are led by Brock Purdy. You know the story, taken last in the 2022 draft. The last two seasons, he has led the Niners deep in the playoffs, and it's his third season, Greg, as the QB for San Francisco.
I always love going down to the field in pregame, Mike, and just seeing how certain guys approach their pregame warmups and their routine leading up to kickoff. And I really liked what I saw out of him. He had a really interesting level of focus. He had all of his wide receivers around. He was getting them all involved, throwing the ball, getting on the same page, timing, rhythm in the passing game. They're hoping all these extra reps, not only leading up to this week in practice, but here on game day, if they can carry that over after the game starts, they're expecting to have a lot of success here, especially early.
Second down and 8. Here's Purdy. Gets this one into the hands of Juwan Jennings. And he is out of bounds on the other side of midfield. A pickup there of 28 yards.
These are the chunk plays they thought they could get here against this pass defense. They thought the passing game favored their offense in this matchup, and I think we can expect this to be the case the rest of the game.
A touchdown apiece here in the first quarter of play. Pair of sevens on the scoreboard. And we're back in the Bay Area after this.
Okay,
Here's first and 10. On the ground is Mason. And they bring him down, but not until they get inside the 30-yard line.
Mike, the old adage, you run to set up the pass. This modern offense nowadays, we're starting to see that flipped upside down on its head. Typically, the success of the passing game is what allows teams to have success like this in the run game.
They'll run. This is Mason. Finding space at the 15. He's taken down just shy of the 10.
Let's give some love to the big guys up front here, Mike. The offensive line is looking good here early to start the game. A couple nice big explosive runs. Expect them to continue to lean on the big guys up front as the rest of this game unfolds.
We can still get a first down at the 1. First and 10, they go from the 11. A run. And here's Mason. And he'll get forward for a couple. It's second down. To throw, Purdy. Toward the middle of the field that time, but incomplete. He was trying to hook up with Deebo Samuel that time. Now it's going to be third down.
They went for it all on that one and just a little bit off. Ball winds up hitting the ground. They've got to move forward. The opportunities are out there. Better execution, better location, and they got some big plays in their future.
That's hauled in at the 2. And he'll take it on in. Kyle Juszczyk. Touchdown, 49ers. Moody now for the extra point. It's up and through. And the 49ers will move out to a 14-7 lead. So, following that touchdown, Moody is back out to kick it off. This is going to be taken in at the 3. Across the 20, they'll mark him down before the 25-yard line. That's where the offense will take over. Here's Dak Prescott, and the Cowboy offense set to go again. They trail down 14-7 as they'll come up for 1st and 10. They'll run with Dowdle. And he'll bring this to about the 25. Devondre Campbell brings him down. Look him up on a 2nd down and 8.
Yeah, here we go. Right there.
Now Prescott. This one is caught by Turpin. And they're going to mark him down up past the 35.
They call this the alley. So it's the area between the hash marks and the numbers. And depending on what defense they're in, there is a lot of space to be had down those seams. So if this defense doesn't make a couple of adjustments, I wouldn't expect this offense to target any other place on this field.
and he's brought down after a gain of a couple. Second down, Prescott. Over the middle to his tight end, Ferguson. And he'll be marked down at the 45-yard line.
This is what every offense looks to do, Mike. They want to attack the middle of the field. That's the most valuable real estate in football. And oftentimes, that's where the chunk plays come. Give it to your receiver on the move and let them do the rest.
They'll break the huddle. Coming up now for first and 10. Now, man, back for a second go-around with the Cowboys. Ezekiel Elliott. Give him 15 more on that one. They are on the move. It's a first down.
We've seen this trend throughout the league, Mike. Offensively, everyone wants to have depth at the running back position. Yeah, it's great to have one guy. But if you could have two or three that could all come in and contribute on the ground, that's the goal, and we're seeing it here.
Play action now. Prescott. That's going to be intercepted. It is picked up by the rookie safety.
When you find yourself in this situation, you're on defense. You're defending your own goal line. You got to take some chances. You got to try to force a turnover and make a play and get off the field. That's exactly what this defender did. Takes a chance, bets on himself, and comes away with a pick to save them some points.
Here's the San Francisco offense, ready to take possession of the ball once more. We'll see how they want to attack things here, backed up deep in their own end. It's first and 10. They'll start this one with a three tight end look.
Let's go.
Ready. They'll begin here on the ground. Up the sideline to the 40. Big jump out of bounds, just shy of midfield. And he continues to have success running the ball here in the first half, as he's closing in on 100 yards already. They'll stay on the ground. And they'll move this one down inside the 40-yard line.
And a nice pickup there by the back with an explosive run play. And it's important to point out, Mike, this offensive play caller, he's still working off that opening script. It doesn't necessarily have to just be the first possession. Using formations, using run game and pass, unmask the defense and understand where to take the play calling as the game unfolds.
Right back to him on first down. And he'll lean forward, getting this to about the 35. Osa Odighizuwa there on the tackle. Two minutes to go here, till halftime. Greg and I back with you from Santa Clara in a moment. Here's second and 6. From the gun, it's Purdy. This throw, left side, caught by Kittle. And they'll work this close to a first down, maybe just a tad short.
The drag route is such a good way to get the ball early into the hands of your tight end and take some pressure off the quarterback and give him an easy completion. The size and the athleticism allows them to try to pick up more yards, but do it after the catch.
Can they keep this drive rolling? Here is third and inches. That's caught left side. It's complete. And he's going to have the first down taken down after a short pickup of 5, but it will keep the drive going. Shotgun snap to Purdy. He's got a man. That's Kittle. And no chance to turn and go. That one good for just a couple.
And this is where the versatility of the tight end position really starts coming into play. Not only do they have to line up with their hand on the ground, but they can occasionally split out in the slot. And man, they're too fast for linebackers, and a lot of times they're too big for defensive backs.
It's going to be a first down, a pickup of 9.
I really like the balance that they've showed so far on this drive, Mike, and what that does is it makes the defense have to defend the entire field. The run game and the pass game, everything looks the same. There's no tells, so they can't afford to just dial up certain schemes to take away a run or a pass. They've got to defend the entire playbook, and so far they've done a great job on this drive doing just that.
Timeout 49ers, that is their second.
There's no more efficient play in the NFL, Mike, than the play-action passing game, and you can see here why. You make the defense have to honor both the run and the pass, and he's able to pick up a nice gain to his tight end.
So Jake Moody now out for the field goal. He'll bang that one through. It's good. And the Niners can tack on 3 more, extending the lead here late in the first half.
And that's a really nice boost here before the break. I mean, you work the clock well, you're able to steal some points. The biggest thing is you're able to build a little momentum now going into the locker room at halftime.
So 2 seconds left to play, and the kick's away. This returnable from the 4. And he's going to be taken down as time runs out on this first half of play. So we hit halftime here in Santa Clara with the 49ers in the lead. As we'll send you over to Orlando, our EA Sports Halftime Report with the coach, Jonathan, all yours.
Okay, Michael, thanks very much. And with that, we welcome you all into our EA Sports studios. This is the Halftime Report. We saw a fine performance in the first half from the former Mr. Irrelevant, Brock Purdy. He's got a touchdown pass on the ledger as his guys were able to build a double-digit lead.
Both teams ready to get back at it as we get back underway here on EA Sports. Samuel, gonna see what he can do. And he'll be brought down just beyond the 25-yard line. The 49ers offense gonna have a first crack at it as we begin this third quarter. Their lead is 10. They go back to work trying to add to it. It begins with first down. Three tight ends in the game to start the drive. Here's a run to begin this third quarter. Not much happening there, just a short game. Here's 2nd and 9.
Here we go.
Out of the gun. It's Purdy. He finds Bell. That's caught. And they'll bring him down, but not until he gets to the 38-yard line.
Mike, think back to our conversation during the break. We've kind of both asked ourselves, are they content with this double-digit lead? Do they come out and play conservative here in the second half? Well, it took exactly one play to get our answer.
So, 1st and 10 here now at the 38. He'll get about three on that one. It'll be second down. Out of the gun, here's Purdy. Right side, pulled in by Samuel. Well, he's brought down. That pass is going to pick up four and bring up third down. The shotgun. It's Purdy. Open man is Jennings. And he's going to pick up the first down. He knew where that marker was and made sure he got beyond it.
This is a great example of where just having situational awareness is so critical in the huddle. When every one of those receivers, Mike, breaks the huddle and go line up, they've got to know where that first down marker is. If your route calls, get by it, secure the catch, and bring up a fresh set of downs.
Now a give up the middle, and they'll move this one down inside the 40-yard line. And the big night continues. That last run gives him yardage to put him over 100 for the game. Ball rests at the 37. It's first and 10. They'll stick with him again. And he finds a little bit of space. He'll take this forward for a gain of four. Here's a second and six. On play action, here's Purdy. Ah, the pressure, too much, and he goes down.
With the right personnel, the safety position is like the ultimate chess piece, right? You can put him in center field to play pass. You can bring him up and make him a pseudo linebacker, but you also can bring him on pressure, Mike, and that's what this guy does so well. The timing and the speed, he got there in a hurry.
So, backed up after the sack, and now it's third and long. Throwing from the gun is Purdy. He finds his big receiver, that's Jennings. He needed 13 and got 14 for the first down.
It's like a textbook, methodical, efficient NFL drive. 4 for 4 throwing the ball, mixing in some run. You're just marching the ball downfield at your will, and they get a fresh set of downs now to see if they can convert this nice drive into some points.
They'll come up here first and 10. A handoff as they try to run it here. And a nice run. Get them about 9. It'll bring up second down. Play action now. Purdy. A short one there. Caught by Kittle. And they'll pick up the first down. A gain of about 4.
And this is the blueprint, Mike. The ability to sustain and maintain possession and methodically move the ball down the field in the process. The defense has had no answers up until this point. And now the next step is, can they come away with 6? Because anything less than that, after this long drive, would be a bit of a letdown.
Now give on the ground, and he will score. Gordon Mason, touchdown San Francisco.
That's a heck of a run right there. And I can't tell you, Mike, how many running backs coaches I've heard over the years say, your responsibility with the ball is to make the first guy miss. We can't block everybody on the field. That's the role of a good running back. And you see it here. All it takes is one missed tackle to get this guy in space, and he's able to do the rest with his legs and take it all the way.
On is Moody to add the extra point. The kick is good. And the 49ers up their lead. It's now 24-7. So, following that touchdown, Moody is back out to kick it off. On the return, here's Turpin. And he's brought down right at the 25-yard line. The Cowboys offense getting ready for their opening possession of this second half. The deficit is 17, so they got to start cutting into it soon. See if it starts here. First and 10. Scott. He's got that complete to Turpin. And he's brought down after a gain of 6 on first down.
The receiver thought he had a nice soft spot in that zone coverage, and he settles down to give a nice target to the quarterback. But the defense had eyes on him the entire time. Secure rally tackle prevents that from turning into a big play.
Now Prescott gonna make the read and keep it himself. And this is going to be a Cowboys first down as the tackle's made just shy of the 40.
Sometimes, Mike, the best plan is also the simplest plan. And for this team, just snap the ball to your quarterback, let him find some daylight, and go get that first down himself.
So from the 39, they come up on first and 10. Prescott now. There is Ferguson, the tight end. And they'll get about half what they needed. It's a pickup of 5 and sets up second and 5. So, 3 quarters have come and gone. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL. On EA Sports. They'll come up here on second down and 5. Operating from the gun, here's Dak. The open man is Tolbert. And he'll be taken down. The gain is 6, and it's a new set of downs. He picked up the first down.
Defense does a nice job here initially using zone coverage to take away the middle of the field. That's the most valuable real estate in football. Quarterback gets off his first read, sees some openings to the sideline, and him and his receiver are able to connect.
Short throw, caught by Ferguson. And they'll get about half of what they needed. It's a pickup of 5 and sets up second and 5.
So the hope is when you call these underneath drag routes, you're trying to have your tight end come out the backside of the defense in space. So when you put the ball on them early, it leads to big yards after the catch. In this case, they don't get the real big play they were hoping for, but they'll definitely take it.
And it'll be a short pickup that's not enough for the first down.
When you put plays like this on tape, it sends a message to every defender across the league. When you play this offense and this guy has the ball, you better bring it when you come to contact him, because if not, you're going to be on the wrong end of it.
It's 3rd and 1, and here's Prescott. And he's going to have the first down. It is a gain of 6. Good conversion on third down.
When you decide to throw the ball on 3rd and 1, typically, Mike, what you're doing is you start from the top down. If you have the big shot downfield, take it. If not, the quarterback works through his progression, finds the medium target, picks up a first down.
They'll throw again. Dak. There's that man again. Another catch.
The drag route. We used to say this is day one install. Every single offense in the NFL has this sort of route, especially for the tight end position. And depending on the speed and the run after catch ability of the tight end, sometimes it can lead to some of the biggest gains.
Again, Prescott to the air. To the left side, caught by Lamb. Give him 14 on that one. First down, Cowboys.
And this is a tricky part of the game for any defense. You find yourself protecting a late lead, and the age-old question is, do you remain aggressive? Do you try to just keep the ball from being thrown over your head and make everything be tackled and played in front of you? That's what every defensive coordinator struggles with, so they can't get too soft here.
To the goal line and in. C.D. Lamb. Touchdown, Cowboys. Well, Greg, the light's still on way down at the end of the tunnel here. They are climbing back into this one with that touchdown here in the fourth quarter.
And they have a tall task ahead of them, Mike, but they have a chance. I mean, we've seen stranger things happen. They got a 2-possession game here late. They're going to need a couple stops, and they're going to need a couple things to bounce their way.
The kick is good. Makes the score Niners 24, Cowboys 14. Brendan Aubrey.
So now, after the touchdown, out is Aubrey to kick this one away. On the return, it's Ronnie Bell. Oh, he's got room past the 30. And he'll be out of bounds on the return. And the drive will begin there. The Niners offense and their running back set to go once more. They'll have very good starting field position as they set up past the 40. Set to go now on 1st and 10.
Here we go, set. Go.
His drive will start on the ground. He is met and dropped. Good defense. Loss of a couple on that play.
At this stage in the fourth quarter, great job by the defense, understanding exactly what the offense is trying to do. They're trying to bleed the clock, shorten the game. They completely sold out to stop the run, able to take them down for a loss.
Here we go.
Last play went the wrong way. It sets up 2nd and long. It's 2nd down and 12. Here's Purdy. A very quick throw there, but not on the same page with his target. That's incomplete.
A rare miss for a quarterback that we've seen really come out on fire throughout this entire contest. I mean, his completion percentage, Mike, is well above league average, and frankly, it's really the biggest reason why they find themselves out in front.
This a must stop for this defense. Facing 3rd and long. Now Purdy. He'll get it into the hands of Kittle. A pickup of 15 in the air. It's good for a Niners first down.
That might end up being the backbreaker right now. This defense desperately needed to get off the field and give their offense a chance to cut into this 2-score lead. But instead, they now got to defend a fresh set of downs. And as you look up at this clock, they might be running out of time.
The ground, a 1st down run, and he'll be hauled down at about the 35-yard line.
4-minute offense, Mike, so what does it mean? 1, make the defense use all of their remaining timeouts. 2, continue to pick up first downs, milk the clock. And then 3, If possible, finish with the ball in your hands.
Let's go.
From the 35, it's first and 10. Back to the ground. He'll get it again. Well, they weren't going to get him the second time with the same back. Defense all over that one. They stop him for no gain.
We've seen this back have his way with this defense all game long, Mike. He's up over 100 yards for the game, but this time the defense said, we've had enough. They sold out to stop him. They hold him to no gain.
Let's go now.
They'll try again here. Second and 10. Up the middle they go. And he'll be taken down as the clock ticks towards 2 minutes to play. So 2 minutes left to play in the second half. Greg and I back for the conclusion in a moment. You've got to consider this an absolute must-stop defensively. It's third down. They'll try to get this one on the ground. And they bring him down at the 23, but that will do just fine. Move the chains. First down picked up. They'll turn and hand this one off. And he finds some space, tackled after a gain of 7 on first down. Here's a second and 3 forthcoming.
Go!
Handoff here, up the middle, and nothing on that one. Back to the line of scrimmage, and that is it. This defense in desperate need of a stop, and here comes third down. On the ground is Mason.
Jordan Mason, the ball carrier. Eric Kendricks in on the tackle. A gain of only a yard. It's fourth down.
So Jake Moody now out for the field goal. This just a little more than a chip shot. 32-yard attempt. Moody's kick is good. And the 49ers add on to their lead.
And this is what you want. I mean, you clearly have the advantage, but you want to continue to apply pressure. Can you score every time you get the ball? They're able to do that here. They tack on 3 and extend their lead.
Moody comes back on the field after making the field goal. He sets a kickoff. This is fielded inside the 5. And he'll be brought down past the 25. Decent field position to start this drive. The Cowboys offense about ready to take over once more. The deficit is double digits, so work to do as they begin this drive with 1st and 10. They'll drop to throw. He's going to let one go deep for Lamb. And this will be incomplete. He was trying to get it to C.D. Lamb. And it'll bring up second down.
This is one of those situations that plays directly into the hands of the defense because think, Mike, they know this offense has to be one-dimensional. This has to be a pass. So what do? They bring in extra defensive backs. They clog up the back end. And at the end of the day, there's just nowhere for the offense to go with the ball.
They'll be forced to just throw that one away. It's incomplete.
You can't fault the quarterback on this one, Mike. He really didn't even have much of an opportunity. By the time he hit the top of his drop and got his eyes downfield, the defense was all over him, and he really had no choice but to just get that ball out of his hand and live to play another snap.
Yeah! On third down, Prescott. It's going to be pulled in by Dowdle. And out of bounds he goes, just shy of midfield. They'll pick up 23 on that one. That's good for a Dallas first down.
It's been tough sledding for this offense all day today, Mike, but especially here in the second half. So they are just in desperate need of a spark, just something to get their offense into a little bit of a rhythm if they want to have any chance to find themselves back into this game here late.
Pass completed right side to Ferguson. That's a gain of 11, and they'll move the chains with another first down.
One of the things that makes him one of the best receivers in the NFL, Mike, is his ability to create separation downfield. He makes it so easy for his quarterback to not only find him, but to constantly create a nice throwing window like he did right there.
He's got his man on the in route. Yes, taken in over the middle. And they'll get about half of what they needed. It's a pickup of 5 and sets up second and 5. And the rush gets home. He'll go down. They got him. That is Leonard Floyd, the veteran who got to the quarterback. So the faithful here at Levi's Stadium are rewarded. It's a win for the 49ers. And right away you can point to the turnover pattern. Always key. Tells the story so often. It did here again today. Their offense didn't turn it over at all. They finished on the plus side with the takeaways. As a result, they're going to come away with the victory. And that'll do it for my partner, Greg Olson. For our entire team, I'm Mike Tirico. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. The 49ers get the win here at home as we say so long from Santa Clara.